Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. On the agenda tonight, we're going back to 2012, and we're going to be looking at Heart's tribute to Led Zeppelin with their performance of Stairway to Heaven. So let's get the girls and the guys up on screen and see how they get on.
There's a lady who's sure all that glitters is gone, and she's buying a stairway to hell. When she gets there, she knows if the stores are all closed, with a word she can get what she came for. She's buying a stairway to hell. There's a sign on the wall, but she wants to be sure, 'cause you know sometimes words have two meanings. In the tree by the brook, there's a songbird who sings. Sometimes all of our thoughts are misgiven. Ooh, makes me wonder. Ooh, makes me wonder. There's a feeling I get when I look to the west, and my spirit is crying for leaving. In my thoughts I've seen rings of smoke through the trees, and the voices of those who stand.
I'm just going to jump in here. The link to this is going to be in the description below, and I suggest you watch it the whole way through, because the thing about this performance and this composition is the flow that you get within. And if you interrupt it like I'm doing, obviously you're not going to get that flow. So definitely watch it the whole way through and then maybe come back to this video, because breaking this down, it's one of those videos that you almost can't break it down because it's so good in terms of the original composition, but also the way that Heart and the whole band here pull this off seamlessly, dynamically. And whenever I'm watching any cover of Stairway to Heaven, as soon as the vocal comes in, I just always think how great the original vocal was by Robert Plant, because bear in mind here, we've got a female vocalist with Anne, and what a vocalist she is. So her vocal range is going to already be sitting in that space, already in that range at that pitch, Whereas Robert Plant had one of those voices that just drifted up there seamlessly, and he got so much expression into his voice. So more often than not, you will be seeing Led Zeppelin tracks being covered by female singers because Robert Plant's voice was so difficult for guys to try and sing authentically. But here as well, Anne, of course, a really top vocalist, and it's great to have a look at Heart covering a Led Zeppelin track, just because I've done both of those bands in isolation. So now bringing together those strong points of the Led Zeppelin writing ability and the Heart performance really does make for something special. And just a quick footnote, I'm sure you've already noticed that we've got Jason Bonham here on drums as well. So it adds a really cool element to this performance. And getting into the playing and Nancy in the intro, because it must have been so nerve-wracking to actually have Jimmy Page watching you play your guitar from so close. But let's break this down, because everybody knows that this isn't the hardest thing to play technically on the guitar, but on an acoustic, if you make any mistakes, you've got absolutely nowhere to hide. And it's not the easiest thing to play on the guitar. Everybody knows with this intro, getting your bar chords in place, getting it all to ring out perfectly, it is almost misleading when you hear it, because it sounds like it's easy to play. But actually, get your fingers on that fretboard and getting it all super clean and super accurate every time is tricky. Especially imagine yourself playing in front of Jimmy Page, having to nail this on an acoustic guitar when you are the only instrument that is starting the track. So of course, Nancy is a top player, so she absolutely nails it. And then the way that Anne comes in with that vocal, absolutely spot on. In my last Heart video that I did, they absolutely kill it in terms of main melody line, those vocals spot on, harmony vocals as well. And the great thing about Anne's voice is her dynamic range, which is one of those things that is absolutely a necessity if you're trying to sing this track and singing a vocal that Robert Plant has sung before, because he had that ability to take his voice from such a small place to the biggest place you've ever heard. It's one of the best songs ever written, and it takes you on such a dynamic journey, and it's something that you can certainly look at and take note of in this performance. And actually, with so many other really big bands who had massive hits that were quite progressive and did go on a journey, if you listen back to them, they've all got that dynamic change in them, often starting with one instrument and a voice. And it takes that one instrument and a voice to then a full band and a really open sound. Sometimes if it's a rock band, really heavy, overdriven guitars, maybe some riffs in there. So you go from that really small place into now that full band sound that can melt your face. And when you look at all the great compositions of all time, they've all got that dynamic change in there. And more often than not, the composition will take you full circle. So by the time you finish, you're finishing the song exactly the same way you started it. So if you started with a vocal and, say, for example, piano, at the end of the track, you then have a vocal with a piano just to complete that journey. And this is an absolutely classic example of a journey that takes you all over the place but brings you back home at the end. And with this particular performance, they add in extra elements to embellish the sound even more. And the reason that that can even happen in the first place is because of the strength of the original composition. And this is what you'll find, is that with great compositions, you can take it to a full band and you can embellish it almost as much as you want because the melody is so strong. You very rarely have a really weak song that you then hear live and they turn it into a masterpiece. It doesn't work that way. So we've just had that gradual incline dynamically so far, and it is like climbing a mountain. We will be on the top of the mountain at some point, but with these top performances, you want to look out for this and just see how the higher up the mountain you get, generally the more instruments will come into the mix just to add that open sound, especially with Jason coming in now with drums. We've now got that percussive element, so the sound is really going to open up, and you'll find that more and more gets added to this sound to keep climbing up that mountain to take you to that crescendo. This was originally written into the track, so it's not that they're applying this to a song that didn't have it already. That was the beauty about the original track, is the journey and the dynamics that they actually got down in the studio. Let's get back into it. It's just a spring before the May. Yes, there are two paths you can go by. There we have it. You can't ask for more than a standing ovation from Robert Plant and Jimmy Page. What a fantastic performance. And all of those elements in there. I mean, at the end, if you don't get a lump in your throat, then there's probably something wrong with you. Especially, you could see that Jason was just holding himself together. Jason absolutely nails this for the whole performance. When we've got that push in tempo, it's such an important part of the track for everybody to be absolutely on the ball because it takes it to that other place. You can't get to that other place if you were to play this whole track at the same tempo. And just a word on the guitar solo as well, because this kind of solo, the solo that Jimmy Page played on the original, when you listen to it, you can see kids playing this and it's not really technically difficult to get down. It is difficult to express the same way. Let's get that straight. But it's not difficult to play the notes. The difficult part is writing it in the first place, and this is something that does get lost with a lot of people that might play guitar or might listen to a lot of music. They'll see somebody playing a cover of somebody else's track or playing a solo of somebody else's, and they'll think, oh wow, this person's amazing because they can play that solo so well, and they might be so young. But it's great to have technique and it's great to be able to express, but then to be able to write it comes under a totally different heading. And Jimmy Page is one of those guitarists that can just write. He's got that ability to put together a riff and a hook and something that you're just going to be able to sing back. And this solo is a classic example of it because you just want to hear it note for note. You don't want the player to go anywhere else but where you know the journey goes. And that is the sign of a great solo, but also a great guitarist. And another thing that is evident when we look into the audience, just the way that music can bring everybody together, because everybody's getting into this here, and it's almost like, especially with this track, that there's no genre to it, because we've almost got a folk kind of intro, just a guitar, acoustic guitar with a vocal, and it goes from that into almost a hard rock guitar solo and classic rock backing. So we have such a journey there, not only with the composition, but in the style of music and the genre that we go through. This is one of those videos that could go on all night because of the original composition, the different things you can take from that, but also this live rendition where vocally, absolutely stellar by Anne, and we know that Nancy's got the ability to do those harmony vocals and has got a great voice in her own right, let alone playing great rhythm guitar here, and like I said, the importance on that intro. But the way that everything comes in, again, if you were listening out and taking a note of that dynamic journey, as we were climbing higher up the mountain, we even had that brass element that came in. And then right at the end for that crescendo, we got that full choir. And that is what makes the difference and absolutely pushes it over the edge to just get such a great journey. You can see how we went to the top of that mountain and then at the end, after the applause was ringing out, because everybody knows that we're going to get that final line by Anne right at the end of the track, bringing it right back to where you started. Getting a standing ovation from Robert Plant and Jimmy Page is all you need to know about this performance, because they will have the highest bars that can ever be set, and they will be able to listen to things that nobody else will ever be able to hear because they wrote it in the first place. But thank you so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at, and keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the next one. Rawr!